Tuesday, October 3rd, 2023. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month. Come to the library this month to add to our Hispanic Heritage Recognition Wall. All you have to do is fill out a paper with your favorite part of Hispanic culture or someone that you admire and why.
Lincoln, to participate in field trips, dances, and other fun things, you must have no ISS, no OSS, or PPA, and less than 4 tardies. This is an all-year-long standard, so keep it in mind. Fit Club starts October 16th. See Miss Weddington before, then get a permission slip. Permission slips must be signed before you can participate.
Tonight, our volleyball team takes on New Augusta. Good luck, Lion.
Hello, Lincoln. I have missed you so much, but I am really, really excited that our Roar staff is in full swing and has taken over the launching of the LMS Roar. Isn't that awesome? Today, though, I needed to pop in and talk to you a little bit about what's going on this week. This week, nationwide, is Banned Books Week. And while we at Lincoln might celebrate it and dive into that a little deeper in the weeks to come, you know, we got conferences and junk this week. I did want to talk to you about some of the statistics that came out this year. In the 2023 Banned Books Week, our theme is Let Freedom Read. And that sounds kind of corny, but it is your right to read. And here in America, we want you to celebrate freedoms. And that includes the right to read books, which is really important to me. In 2022, so we're looking at the 2022 data in 2023, 1,269 challenges were investigated. That is nearly double the 729 that were challenged in 2021. So we can see a real uptrend in the number of books that are being challenged. Of all of that, over 2,500 unique titles were brought to the table and questioned and had to be defended by librarians, teachers, people in my field. Most of those challenges centered around concerns about LGBTQ themes, LGBTQ authors, Indigenous people, or people of color as the main characters or as the writers themselves. I say this to you, I want to share this with you because I want you to be aware of what people don't want us reading. My favorite thing about books is that if you don't like it, you don't have to read it. So I encourage you to read things that make you uncomfortable. Certainly, I want you to find books that you love and that are interesting to you and have characters that you love. But sometimes I want you to read things that stretch you a little bit. Your teachers are giving you material that you didn't know before. And I think that reading for pleasure can be the same thing. It can show you perspectives into other worlds. As we go through Banned Books Week and as we come back and we hit on the topic of banned books, hit on the topic of the things that they don't maybe want you reading, I want you to decide for yourself and let freedom read. Let's talk about Chromebook care. Whew. Whew. You guys have had your new Chromebooks, unless you're a sixth grader, you've had your Chromebooks for about 60 days at this point. In those 60 days, the library has touched over 153 Chromebook problems. That does not include if you were sent by a teacher to just, it won't turn on, and I fixed it. 159. And that's not all of them. This week, though, I have seen computers coming in with keys completely gone, screens cracked. I have no idea how this happened. I just opened the bag and it was cracked. People with their hinges broken off and picking apart the outside of their Chromebooks, as well as writing on the exterior. While you might look at these problems and think that's not that big of a deal, what I want you to consider is that you have had your computer for 60 days. Your new laptop cost around $350. You are responsible for it. It's a lot like a library book. If you lose it or break it, you may be responsible for the charges. A new screen could cost you around $40, a new keyboard around $60, and a new device around $350. New Chromebook bags are $20 and Chromebook chargers are $27. Please take care of your school-issued devices. If your mouse stops working or your keys stop working, please allow our IT department to take a look at that. Do not take it upon yourself to try to fix the item yourself. Do not pry your keys off. Do not drop your Chromebook on the floor. Do not swing it around in the hallway like a projectile. Please take care of your Chromebooks. Believe it or not, when I went to library school, I was not hoping to play with computers. I do not have any interest or degree in technology. Chromebook problems should be handled during first, second, maybe third period. If you've got a Chromebook issue, bring it to us at the beginning of the day. It is not something that I will look at after lunch.
October 18th, so make sure you got no OSS and no ISS, PPA and PSA,
less than two tardies,
and no refund.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Way to dribble up and down the court, just like I'm the king on the microphone. So it's Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunks and taking it to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley oop. I like the pick and roll, I like the give and go, cause it's basketball, but Mr. Curtis go.
Time for dad jokes.
Time for dad jokes.
What days are the strongest?
I don't know.
Saturday and Sunday. The rest are weekdays.
I just found out I'm colorblind.
How?
The news came out of the purple.
What's the difference between a well-dressed man on a unicycle and a poor-dressed man on a bicycle?
What?
An attire.
Okay.
Have a great day, Lincoln. Do something good with it.
And keep your Chromebooks in their bags
so that way they stay safe.
And keep them in their bags. Because that way they'll stay safe. There you go.
Wait, now that I think of it, I'm running for class president, so you should vote Shalane for class president. But also, I need a vice president, so you should vote Diana Sanchez for vice president.
I'm Diana Sanchez, and you should vote me for vice president.
Go Lions! So make sure to vote on October 4th.
Hello, my name is Yamala Zarko, and I will be running as class president through 2023 through 2024.
And I want your attention.
I am very responsible, hardworking, and capable of becoming your class president. You will have no regrets on voting for me.
I will work hard to make sure our school is safe and welcoming for all and make sure that every voice is heard. Once again, my name is Yamala Zarko and I hope to have your vote.
Don't act like I'm average.
Get you on the home.
Vote Eva for secretary.
Get you what you want.
Vote Eva for secretary.
Vote Eva for secretary.
Vote Eva for secretary.
You should vote for secretary.
But I don't
vote
want you
Eva.
Secretary. As secretary, I'll make sure everybody here at Lincoln Middle School will know all the upcoming events, due dates, and opportunities. Some special qualities of me is that I'm responsible, I can write neatly, and I pay attention to detail.
I'm also good on time and very organized.
If you're still not sure if you should vote me, then let me show you this clip.
Thank you for taking time to watch this video. Please consider voting me as your secretary. Your vote matters. Go Lions!
Today, I will explore the symptoms of not voting for Abigail. Having Abigail as your vice president is proven to increase lifespan, gain powers, and more.
Hi, my name is Rihanna and I'm running for class president. You guys should vote for me because if you do, I'll make sure we're running in a safe and healthy environment. Make your vote count and go vote October 4th.
Vote for Rihanna.
Finally finished making posters for today.
As some lovely workers, we can take a mini break.
So you may be wondering what these posters are about. Well, you see, I'm actually running for student council treasurer. And if you're asking yourself, oh, why should I vote you? Well, that is because I am a very dedicated student. I am very responsible for this job. Not only that, I also promise to do my best as your student council. Not to mention, I am also very organized. So please make sure to vote Isabella Rivera for student council. Thank you.
Who do you are running the school? Here's why you should vote me, Kai Bonanet, as vice president. First of all, I am a responsible, hard worker. I'm also a team worker as well, and I can get you what you need to succeed this school year. Vote me if you know best for LMS.
Hi, Lincoln. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Yasmin. For those of you who do know me, my name is Yanni. I'm in eighth grade, and I'm going to be going for treasurer as student council for this year. I wanted to let you know some reasons as to why you should vote me. I'm really good at how I take care of my situations and how I handle them. I really care about how I do my responsibilities and how to organize things. I feel as if I'll be a great candidate for this year's treasurer, and you can count on me. I'll be great for this year's treasurer and also add-ons. I'm really kind and I'm really caring. And I feel as if I'm a good person. I really hope to be able to win this year's election, and that's why you should vote me for treasurer.
Responsible and respectful. Some things I can offer as your vice president are more fundraisers for extras, more activities for each grade, and an enjoyable school year.
Vote Brielle!